Hi everyone. Welcome to Ken's Lab. Today I have a Crosley Fiver. It's a model 20AP, I think. Even though it says model 20 in the back. Broadcast with shortwave from 6 megahertz to 15. Dial works, appears to be working fine. This is the selector. Broadcast a short wave, and this has to be your on and off volume. The grill looks okay, the grill cloth, not bad. Case cabinet here has speckles on it, paint. It's the veneer. Looks like they had tape on it. I guess I'll get that off with some steel wool. Oh, I can feel it. All right, here it's got a little chip here and here, but it's no big deal. It's under the bottom. Let me see. This side seems pretty good except for the tape. I'm thinking that this is the original cord. I'm not sure, it looks like it. Let's see what these are. These gotta be external antenna. It's a loop antenna with a switch for police and broadcast. Well, they say police, but I don't know what they're saying. They're saying shortwave. Well, we'll watch the other switch. Unless it's a tone. There could be a tone. High and low tone on there. Not sure yet. Antenna. Looks to be in good shape. It is a power transformer set. It doesn't have a back, it's missing the back. Okay, this antenna is about how far it goes. Keep in mind. Yeah, there's a switch back there, a couple. Well, I have to be desoldered. Oh, this capacitor looks. Let's see if I can turn on the side to see it. This capacitor does not look original. Yeah, they took off the can, you can tell. And they put this one in here. Negative going to ground on this here. On the top of the chassis, and then they put this electrolytic in here. They removed the can and put a paper type, well, you know, it's aluminum under the paper, but paper covered. Tuner. Let's see, it's got a fill coil. Huge rectifier, I believe. That's going to be another 80 or something. No, it's probably a... I don't think so. Probably like a 5Y3 or something. I'm not sure. And that's got to be the output. And then they got... Let's just see. One way back behind there. And this one and that. The other three are shielded because of being around the... IFs. So let me take it out of here. Watch, we got here. There she comes. Oh, great. The dial comes with it. Of course, the dial will come with it, but that's the cover, ain't it? I like when the dial comes with it because that way you get it. It's easier to align. Like I said, my lamp, so I move this. Let's see how the speaker looks. Got to know how the speaker looks. Looks like it's been patched in a couple spots. Wait a minute. It looks like maybe in a couple spots, but don't look too bad. Definitely got. Looks like it's missing the gasket for this cone. Yeah, so I see 1, 2, 3, 4, and this one probably been replaced over time. A 30 microfarad. I wonder what that's about. They didn't have enough. You only see like two coming out of here out of the one that they replaced, the filter one. So this is probably a 3-1 and they added this one ground to there. I'm thinking this used to be 3, so they added this one and these two. Okay, I got my speaker cover somewhat on there so I can breathe a little bit easier. Got the schematic. It's a for the model 20, but it's supposed to be the same for the 28P also, so we'll see. These four capacitors, film capacitors, they replaced one of the volume, and these three, 1, 2, and 3. Those are correct values, believe it or not. The only one that's different is this electrolytic filter here. It's a 30, it's supposed to be. Shows 320s, and I looked at the one that they put in here, and those are 220s, but this one's a 30. Now I want to see if I can power this on. This is not a, you know, a leakage test. This is just an ESR, but it's, you know, it's, it'll give me an idea if I can power it on or not. There we go. 17.58 microfarad at 2.0. It's, they're a little high, but not, they're in. And this one says leaky because it's in circle. It ain't leaky. I'm, because the ESR was low. That's right. So I'm going to try it. Hold on. ...118 at the analyzer, should be a little higher here, 121. Good, it'll fall, it'll drop. Let me get this light out, and watch the DBT. It's okay, nothing lighting up so far. How about my dial light? Dial light don't work. Rectification light up.
They don't understand us.
Hey.
And people actually say this nonsense out loud.
What's the chances of me having that right on mine?
People like Judge Looting, still bitter that he didn't make the Supreme Court. This, oh, by the way, used to be a conservative. Donald Trump and his allies and supporters.
Okay.
The army goes out against
sometimes
you,
you work on so many sets, you assume things.
You becomes unclean by some in the night, then he
prior
shall go
to
outside the camp. He shall not come inside.
Getting
the
schematic,
camp.
I looked at this. And okay, that's tone control. So
he
had to
wash with water.
Two.
Sunsets,
then as I got the schematic, I looked at the tone control and showed the potentiometer. So I knew that wasn't right. Then I look back there and I see, well, you think you're looking for a phono jack, but no, it's got three terminals back there. And that's for phono. They look like antenna terminals, so that could throw you off also. So, you know, when you assume stuff, it just happens. But
he may dwell with you in your midst, in the place which he chooses, within one of your gates.
That's it. It's the phono. So it's radio
the daughters of Israel,
and I should have thought of that because I know the switchback that said broadcast and on the back of the antenna has the.
Both of these are an abomination to the Lord your God. You shall not charge interest to your brother.
Has the switch on it for broadcast and a shortwave. Not a spot to put that. Kind of makes you wonder if they even had a back to it. How would you reach that? It sits back, it's recessed inside there. I'll have to look more into that, but definitely now. So that's phonograph and radio volume. And they're showing this tone control potentiometer. That's not in this radio, of course. So now we know what we're up against. So now we know. So I'll get back to you when I start getting some capacitors replaced and check the resistors and see what we've got after that. Okay, I don't have a parts list for this. I can't find one. Radio Museum don't have it. Nostalgia Air don't have it. I can't find it. But they show values on the schematic, and I took out this one, which is the 220. I dropped that screw, couldn't get it out before. So this is the 20 and 20, though, so we're good. But the replacer, this has got to be replaced at 20. Now I saw this resistor in there, kind of like, oh, in my area, so I thought I'd check it out. It's supposed to be a 10K. Now, and I forgot, these older radios, it'll say 10M, for M is for 1,000. If it's meg, it'll say meg. So this was reading 41, just north of 41K. I need a 10K. So what I'm going to do is I want to see what the construction really is of this. If it's wire wound, I don't have one. Oh, yeah, I'd have to look for one anyway. So I'm going to break this. Will I? I did. No, it is not wire wound. See that? It's carbon. So that's good news. Hey, this was just now it won't read 41K, I guarantee. So it's garbage. So here's my 10K I'll put in there. Okay, I run into a little problem here. I got the this is a 20. They're all still assist this, and I put a 22 in. I probably could have went downstairs and found one, but I decided to go with a long one. The axle instead of the radial. There's the resistor I replaced. This one here, back in here, you can't see it, but it's way off. It's, what the heck it was, 56K. And it's reading a lot higher than that, but there's the color code on this. It don't belong there. It's supposed to be a 660 ohm. And this one's off of tower tolerance also, but I'll get those replaced in a minute. I just wanted to see if it worked, and it worked for, a second or two. And the audio transformer worked for about a few seconds, and then all of a sudden it went out. It didn't smoke. It didn't make any. It didn't burn up. It didn't do nothing. It just went out. I tried to open it up. It's the primary side. It's opened, and you got to remove the secondary winding to get to the primary. I was hoping maybe I'd fix the loose wire, but I have no luck with those. So I got this one. It's a smaller one. It's not getting hot. It's handling.
Maybe Fran and I could somehow. And then I heard her coming down the street. I looked. It was her, all right. I was scared. I just waited where I was, trying to get my breath.
The reason I did it because I wanted to see if the short way worked, because there was that wire that I don't think I mentioned to you before. I think it's back here, right here. It's been disconnected. I looked on the schematic and I can't see that it goes anywhere. I wanted to try my shortwave just to see if that works, because I don't know why they cut that wire out and I can't see where it goes anywhere. Not at all. So let me put it on pause for a second. I'll leave this transformer out. It'll mount where it's at. It's all what I have. I like to have a little bigger one, but here's what I got. Let me get the shortwave set up. I'll be right back. Okay, I got it set up. See, I got it on 7 megahertz. First of all, I got to put this switch on. Shortwave. Which way you go down? Right now it's on shortwave. Okay, it's off. I'll tell you that much. I don't have to get that up. I've got the bottom chassis restored. I got 320s in here. Actually, one's a 22. Because I wanted an axle instead of a radial. And that would be the cathode bypass, so that's fine. Whoever did this did a pretty good job. I mean, as far as using the right capacitors, he never changed. Oh, he did. No, he didn't change any of the resistors. I did change, I don't know, 4 of them, I think. Yeah. Some of these older sets, they have odd values on resistors and stuff. And you're forced to put them in series and get them as close as possible. So I had the 2 in series. This one and that one. This is a floating one. I hate floating connections, but sometimes like this one here, but that's the way they did it on the factory, so that's the way it goes. This one way back in here behind this coil, I think that's an oscillator coil. I don't think that's it's back there. It was real hard to get to that one. I thought I got another one pulled here, and I thought I had another one. I don't know. I did get some sleep and I've been faking all right. So it's all left with restored.
Well, that all depends on how much on the job my private genie is. Which right now I think he's
10 megahertz.
Just my luck.
Well, at least you're feeling better. That's something.
I suppose. But hey, wait a minute. Suppose the young lady you came down here to see won't talk to you.
That sounds great. Let me turn this off. Turn my iPhone off. I'm not going to go through all the stations showing you. It's lined up nicely. I had both. Usually I can't get away with that.
Yeah, she's inconsolable.
This is broadcast.
Perhaps, as a dear friend of the departed, you might give her words of comfort. Please go in.
Thank you.
That's broadcast.
Quietly to herself.
900 kilohertz.
She turned around when she heard me come in. Her eyes lit up with hatred, and suddenly she grabbed something from her pocketbook and held it at me. It was a .45, and her hand was shaking.
I left the grill speaker cloth on there. It don't look that bad. It I didn't have an exact replacement. I did have, let me see, this one, which probably wouldn't have looked too bad, but it's kind of worked out, but it's not that bad. But I'll leave it.
Punish the people responsible for your husband's death.
Yeah, I believe you. I must go and follow.
So yeah, that's it. It's restored.
Tell me something about yourself and your husband, Mrs. Julius.
Yeah, it's an old story now.
And it works fine. It looks great. It looks good. It works great.
Then my children and I, we were released, came to this country.
That's the speaker down around where the gasket was missing on the cone. It was glued before. Somebody did a good job, but removed the gasket, and I put more glue down on it to make sure it stays down.
In this country, he did not dare come to me.
So that's the, like I say, the final product.
You see, most people that followed your husband this time weren't Nazis.
Turned the light off.
After him, they were after something he was carrying.
A dial.
In Lisbon, didn't he go to a dentist named Laverne?
Yeah.
And didn't Laverne put an odd-shaped...
This is a little yellowish, turned a little yellowish, but...
So he smuggled the candy tooth out of Portugal and in it. You
can't really tell it because of the gold background on the sides, and I did put that 47 bulb in there, so.
I doubt it very much, Mrs. Julius.
No, surely they would.
That's why I want to make a request of you.
So that's
you see,
it.
Others have died besides your husband because of this thing.
That's the final.
You will die unless you do as last I ask.
Edition of this Crosley radio.
First started, I was engaged to marry a man named Kemidoff in London.
The Russian, yeah. Government mentioned him something about an old manuscript.
Yeah, I'll find a music channel real fast.
Yeah, it was very old, and Kemidoff said it'd be information.
Real fast, right? I'll get myself in trouble.
Well, you never do nothing to save your doggone soul.
You can hear the hum.
Sam, I love you so much it feels like hate. It feels like...
But now you don't. It's just the transmitter.
No. No, don't answer.
Okay.
It,
relax, Angel.
It's finished.
You'll be okay.
Sam?
I hope you enjoyed it.
Only you.
Maybe got something out of it.
All I want.
I sure did.
Only you.
I mean, I probably repaired one of these back in the day. Who knows?
I'll bet you're home safe.
So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time with another project, perhaps another radio. Yeah, another radio will be coming up. Get some of them out of my stock. Thanks for watching.